This afternoon's first game between Plymouth and Indianapolis Cathedral. Plymouth won it 62-59. Late in the game, Cathedral led 55-54. Plymouth came on, regained the lead at 56-55, and won it by just three thrilling points. We pick up now the highlights of the Plymouth-Indianapolis Cathedral first game this afternoon.
We appreciate you moving.
The opening tap control by the Cathedral Irish, and off they go with two right off the bat. And that is Scotty Hicks. Hicks, Shelton Smith. Shelton Smith has got to be one of the, I don't want to use this word, but it's true, Joe, one of the brashest sophomores you ever run across. He has a personality that just absolutely exudes confidence, and he backs it up. He can play this game. So they've got three or four players who, when one guy gets in trouble, the other can pick up the gap. Deep in that corner, there is the shot from Skiles, the one you're talking about.
That's the one he's going to have to take, because he gets inside. There are too many big people to shut off his offensive move there.
Skiles has six of the 8 points now that the Plymouth Pilgrims have in this basketball game. Smith again, didn't get it this time. Good position on the rebound from Barry Peterson. Peterson bounces it up to Phil Wendell. Rebound saved out back by Samuelson. Put it back in the middle again and give the 2 points to Scott Skiles. Skiles now with three field goals and two out of two from the stripe and an 8 point total, and it's back to a 2 point lead now for Cathedral at 12-10. Hicks. Again, good position by Skiles. You can see why he's the leading rebounder on this basketball club. First off, he's a rather healthy young man. Carries a few pounds of weight on that 6-1 frame, and he's not afraid to go inside with the big fellas. Sissel getting his first two, and it was a 12-6 basketball game, and now it is tied at 12. Change of the lineup now for the Irish. Number 32, Randy Knox, a 6-foot senior, played in 27 games, averaged 1.7, comes into the ball game. Montgomery gets a seat alongside head coach Tom O'Brien across the way. Wendell, the Skiles, penetration back to Phil Wendell, 12-footer. Rebound by Wendell again, and a great play by Phil Wendell. And Plymouth has run off now 8 consecutive points to take the lead at 14-12 with 9 seconds to play in the first quarter. Last time the Irish led, Joe, was 12-10 with a minute and a half to go in the first half. So the Plymouth Pilgrims look for this slam jam here. He has the ball right there. They give him the 15-footer, and he hit it. In fact, this period, Cathedral's 0 for 5 for the line. High ball game of 38. The last time it was tied was way back at 12. Not anymore. Scott Skiles now with 20. Skiles averaging 28.8, top scorer in the Hoosier State. Leads the team in rebounds and assists, and is one-tenth of an assist behind the team leader, Phil Wendell. So he's got great numbers in every category. Hicks puts it in the middle. There was nobody there except the red shirt. Here come the Plymouth Pilgrims again. They're up by two. Tremendous effort from Barry Peterson. 4 minutes and 32 seconds to play. Fourth period. Three-point lead. Now they go inside of the alley-oop. Kenny Barlow very gingerly lays it over the edge of the rim. And Kenny now with 20. Irish have pulled it within one. It's 50-49 with 4 minutes and 20 seconds to play in this fourth and final period. But they try to go a back door, and very quickly Scott Bath steals it. They come now to the big man, and they got it. Carl Daniels on his sixth point, and with 4:07 to go, Cathedral goes back in front by 51-50. Let's see how the Pilgrims react to the pressure. They had a 5-point lead about 2 minutes ago.
Ron Sissel getting ready to re-enter now, a starter for Plymouth.
Phil Wendell at guard. Here's the one man they want to have ball. The ball, Skiles. Oh, great pass inside. Todd Samuelson to Jamie Johnson. Johnson with 8.
2:38 to go in the game.
Cathedral basketball. Shelton Smith loves this kind of a situation. 55-54, Cathedral by one. Let's see what Plymouth's game plan may be. Wendell looking in the middle. They go in low now to Sissel, back in that lineup despite the four personal fouls. Out to Skiles, who has just been unbelievable today. Off to Wendell again. Penetration. They dump it up to Skiles. He shuffles it down low to Johnson. They give it back the other side, and they got it to Ron Sissel. Tremendous ball handling, Joe.
Great pass in there now. Jamie Johnson threw that ball right across the lane to Sissel, and he got that hook. It's a big one to put him 1 point up.
And that final score was Plymouth 62-59 over Indianapolis Cathedral. We're back live at Market Square Arena, and joining me now, the very talented coach of Indianapolis Cathedral, who's had another tremendous year with the Fighting Irish. This is Tom O'Brien. Tom, I wish the news had been better for you, but the margin between victory and defeat is oh so close on occasion.
That's right, really. It was a great game, and you know, we're very disappointed we're not in the final game, but it just our luck sort of ran out there at the end. We had a very difficult time hitting free throws. We were 7-for-19, which is 37%. And you can't win the big ones shooting 37%.
Tommy, you did all you could. You tried to get the ball inside to Ken Barlow repeatedly in the second half of the ball game. He had a fine scoring game, but when it was very crucial, Plymouth kind of prevented you from getting the ball inside on occasion.
That's right. They're a very good defensive team. They're a very smart team, and offensively, they're a great passing team. And they're really good, and they were a very difficult team for us to play. And like you said, we didn't get the ball into Kenny enough. I think he was 9-for-12, but guys shooting like that ought to get in a little more often.
Well, going over your roster, I know that it's a predominantly an underclass team, at least among the starters. You had 3 out of 5 that'll be back next year. This bodes well for you in Indianapolis Cathedral.
Yes, we think we'll have a very fine high school basketball team next year. We had an 18-4 reserve team, city champs. A lot of these young men will come back, so we're going to get ready. We're going to give it a shot next year.
What can Plymouth do quickly now against Gary Roosevelt tonight?
I don't think they'll change a thing. They'll play the same type game they played today. They've done it all year. They'll stay basic, fundamental, do their thing, and they're going to be tough to beat.
Well, you're going to be tough to beat next year again, Tom. Thank you very much for joining us. Congratulations on a 27-3 season.
Thank you very much.
Tommy O'Brien, here's Ken Barlow, the All-American High School center from Indianapolis Cathedral. Kenny, you got 22 points in this ball game. I'm sure you would have wanted the ball a little more in the last half.
Yeah, you know, I was trying to get a little more, but Plymouth kept double and triple teaming me underneath the basket. I really couldn't get open, so it was forcing other players to have to shoot. You know, they're pretty good shooters, but we just couldn't get our shots to fall tonight.
You're all set for Notre Dame next year and Digger Phelps, is that right?
Yes, you know, I'm getting ready probably next week and start working out again after I run track. And then, you know, I'll be getting ready this summer to do my best to get ready to play college basketball next year.
Well, you're a marvelous package of basketball talent. I congratulate you on a great career. Wish you well at Notre Dame and South Bend.
Thank you.
Thank you. That was Ken Barlow. Here's Scott Hicks, an excellent junior from Indianapolis Cathedral. You're on your way to an all-star team berth too, Scott. I congratulate you. I'm sure you're disappointed, but what are your feelings at the moment?
Well, you know, it kind of hurts, you know, to lose and everything. I wish we was playing right now, but I think we'll get our team together and we'll be ready for next year too.
What do you work on in your game?
My game, now I got to work on my free throws because that's what, you know, we really lost off of.
Right, you had 37% in this ball game, and that was crucial at stages of this game this afternoon.
Yeah, we missed around 12 free throws, and they, you know, hit the majority of theirs, and that really cost us the game, really.
It was a learning experience, though, for you. I'm sure you'll come back stronger next year.
Yeah, we should.
Good luck to you, Scott.
Thanks a lot.
That was Scott Hicks, and we'll be back at Market Square Arena as we go to the second game highlights in just a moment. Second field goal by Ronaldo Thomas eliminated Evansville Bossy, a team that had been unbeaten going into the game this afternoon. The score was 58-57. Here are the highlights. We pick it up late in the first period, and Gary Roosevelt leads 12-9.
Stolen away. Monty King holds up on the break, comes near side of the sub off the bench, Doug Bell, who has 2 out of 2 from the field. And he has 4 points, and the 7-point lead is top to 1 now. It's 12-11. Near steal as Darryl Scott couldn't find the handle, worked it inside, and Ronaldo Thomas picked up his second bucket of the day. So the Panthers staying in that man-to-man defense.
Both teams playing man-to-man defense, right.
Alley-oop, and they got Bree and got it. Panthers grabbing a look at the big scoreboard in the middle of Market Square Arena. Shows 9, 8, 7. First period coming to a close, down to 4. There's the outside shot that is scored by Winston Garland at the buzzer. 3:39 to go in the first half, 25-24. Bossy's cut the lead to 1. Here's the steal, 3-on-2 advantage for Evansville. They've got the man up court. Oh, great move from Myron Christian. The defensive man was looking for a slam, and he just kind of eased it up over his outstretched hands. And I think for the first time, Boston's got the lead at 26-25. Not anymore, though, because very quickly Ronaldo Thomas taps it over the other end. Thomas now with 7. 3 minutes to play in the first half. 27-26. Roosevelt out in front of Bossy. Good position on the rebound. Put back up and good by Eric Dowell. Eric Dowell has 7 points this period, 16 in the day. And it's a 42-42 tie ball game again. Loose ball in the corner. Bingo. Anthony Stewart is on it again. He has 10 points on 4 field goals and 2 out of 2 from the line. 2:11 to go, Hilliard. Fourth period, 55-51. Roosevelt.
Well, they're still tying for 4 points here.
Tap control by Evansville Bossy. Bossy averages 62.5 points a game. They're on that same mark tonight. Christian,
yes.
Myron Christian has not been that big a factor in the game, but all of a sudden in the fourth period, he has 8 of the 11 points, but the Bulldogs have scored. That's the lead to 2 at 55-53 with 1:48 to go. Garland comes back outside to Ronaldo Thomas.
There it is, right there.
Yeah, they better foul him.
Thomas with 4 personal fouls. Swings it back to Garland again. 1:35 to play. All the way under and back out the other side is Winston Garland. In the background, you can catch some of the Evansville Bossy fans on their feet, waiting and wondering. Missed shot. And an offensive foul called on Gary Roosevelt. 56-53. Gary Roosevelt leads with 1:11 to play. Bossy's got to have the bucket now, and their winless streak comes to an end. Christian again. Couldn't get this one. Yes. Kept up and in beautifully by, I believe, Dave Kendrick.
I give it to David Wright. Yes. Right.
Dave Kendrick, a reserve on the bench, getting his first 2 of the game. 51 seconds to play. 56-55. Roosevelt leads. Roosevelt basketball. Garland comes back outside of Ronaldo Thomas. Thomas being guarded by Monty King. Thomas going one-on-one, now comes out to Garland again. 35 seconds to play. Garland back out to the guard, Anthony Stewart. He had a great third period. Gets the pick and the screen, rolls right side. 25 seconds to go. Bossy may have to commit the personal foul. They do commit the foul.
Here's the ball game.
Anthony Stewart, 91% free throw shooter, is 2 out of 2. You know it, after a great third period, he missed the free throw. 16-15. 1-point lead, Roosevelt. Bossy's got it. Here is the shot by King. No good. Rebounded by Dowell. Up and good. Gary Dowell with 18. And timeout by Gary Roosevelt. What a game it's been, Joe. If you try to tell somebody the fact that Roosevelt was in command the entire ball game, and now with 5 seconds to go, they're down by 1, they never believe you.
You see, unfortunately, they had, what, 7 or 8 point lead when they started holding the ball. They've only scored 1 point. It's the thing that we talked about.
Here we go. Pass comes in. Roosevelt's on the move. It's good. Tremendous play by Ronaldo Thomas. At the buzzer, Roosevelt has won the game.
Back here live at Market Square Arena, Joe Mullen is the brilliant coach of Evansville Bossy, a team that lost only 1 game, and that was this afternoon to Gary Roosevelt in the last second of play. Joe, I congratulate you on a magnificent season. You were undefeated except for 1 game here this afternoon.
Yeah, we
had a super season this year. Anytime you can win 27 in a row, you know, you got to be proud of your kids.
I thought when Derek Dowell made the rebound basket at the end of the floor, it was all over. You were going to be the winner.
Yeah, we did too. We thought, well, there was, you know, lady luck on our side again, and we just had a defensive error in the last 5 seconds, and, you know, those things happen in athletics when you're dealing with 16, 17, 18-year-old kids, but, you know, just that one play wasn't the one that beat us necessarily. You know, we had a lot of other things, bounce the ball here, bounce the ball there, where if it would have bounced our way, we could have been out.
Let me ask you about Gary Roosevelt and Plymouth now. What do you expect in this basketball game? I doubt if Gary Roosevelt will be able to move quite as quickly. I imagine Plymouth will try to control the tempo more. Would you agree with that?
Definitely. I feel like that, you know, in order for Plymouth to win the game tonight, they're going to have to definitely set a much slower tempo than what our game was with Roosevelt this afternoon. And I think Plymouth is a very well-disciplined team. They're an excellent coach basketball team. And you know, it should be a heck of a final.
Well, we enjoyed watching your fine team play this afternoon. We wish you well. I'm sure you'll be back here in the not-too-far distant future.
Well, we hope so.
Good luck to you, Joe Mullen. Coach of the Evansville Bossy Bulldog. Here is Dexter Dowell. Dexter's a junior. He'll be back next year. He's one of the players that your coach, I'm sure, is planning on being brilliant next year. You had a basket this afternoon, looked like it won it for you, and then it got away in the last 4 seconds.
Well, I knew the basket wasn't a victory basket. I told the players to get back. You know, the game wasn't over. It was still 5 seconds. Roosevelt's a quick team. So I really didn't have my hopes up high. I knew we were still in trouble, and which proved we were.
Well, you had a great year.
Thank you.
And you'll be back.
Yeah, I'll be back. I hope we be up in Market Square again.
Okay, and I'll shake hands with you next year here like I did yesterday and almost lose my forearm.
Okay, thank you.
Good luck to you, Dan.
All right.
Here is Myron Christian. Here's a lad who was a cinch to make the All-Star team. He's a senior, had 23 points this afternoon. Congratulations, Myron, on a great career.
Thank you.
Tell me your feelings now.
Well, my feelings is very bad right now. I feel that we should have been out here in this championship game, and I wish it was an exhibition game for us to get a chance to play against All-American Barlow and see how I feel playing against All-American.
Well, you got it going, and particularly in the last three quarters of the ball game today.
Well, yes, it was a good team effort, and we kind of got our tempo going, but we really never did get to play our kind of ball tonight.
You're a tremendous athlete and a marvelous basketball player. I congratulate you and best wishes wherever you go on to college.
All right, thank you.
Good luck to you. Myron Christian, the coach, or rather the basketball star at forward for Evansville Bossy, will be back at Market Square Arena in just a moment. Jack Edison has coached the Plymouth Pilgrims further in a basketball championship than any previous coach in Plymouth history. He's joined me on the edge of the court. Jack, congratulations. You're at the pinnacle here, and your feelings just have to be heavily emotional.
Well, they are. You know, it's an exciting time and an exciting day for us, and we're able to somehow pull one out today, you know, against a pretty good, a real good Cathedral team. So hopefully we can relax and play well again tonight. Let's just see what happens.
The name of the game, tempo here tonight?
I think it will be a lot. You know, Roosevelt is very, very, got two great things going for him. They're so quick getting up and down that floor. Plus, their two inside kids are so physical and strong. That's really a great concern for us. So we hope we can keep it under control.
South Bend LaSalle reminds me a little of Gary Roosevelt.
A great deal, yeah. They've got great quickness and great speed. Roosevelt's a little stronger, a little bigger inside as far as weighing about 230 or 240, whatever they weigh.
Everybody ready to go?
I hope so. I think we are, yeah.
Jack, good luck, best wishes, and this should be a marvelous game, and we wish you well.
Thank you very much, Hilliard.
Jack Edison, the coach of Plymouth, Ron Heflin coaches Gary Roosevelt, and they won this championship in 1968, and I know they'd love to repeat. Ron, congratulations on getting to the championship game here tonight.
Thank you. Thank you, Hilliard. It's a pleasure. It's been a wonderful tournament. And when you get down this close, you don't really have a loser. And we're glad to be here.
You had an emotional game. Are you psychologically back up?
Oh, sure. It only lasts a couple of minutes. I got to come back and play a tougher game tonight. So a minute after it's over, I'm thinking about the next one.
You don't think they're going to really hold the ball on you? They'll play at you, won't they?
Oh, sure, they will. They're going to run the offense. They're a little patient. They're well coached. They're extremely good fundamentalists. And it's going to be a good ball game.
We just have a couple of seconds. You got a lot of points off of your bench this afternoon.
Right. Hilliard, I told you earlier that we'll play 8 or 9 or 10 kids without a fret, too, because we've done it all year. And hopefully they come back tonight and respond the same way.
Ron, congratulations. Good luck in this ball game tonight.
Thank you.
Ron Heflin, that's our preview. And we'll be back with Jerry Baker and Joe Sexton in a moment.
You've been watching Before the Tip-Off from Market Square Arena. Brought to you in part by DeKalb Ag Research and your local DeKalb dealer, supplying Indiana farmers with quality hybrid seed.